Oh, hey guys. Welcome back to the bar for a very special cocktail moment. Now, I know I say very special basically in every single episode, but for this episode, I really mean it. And you know I really mean it because it says it right here in the title, in the graphic, holiday special. What makes this episode special is we've invited hosts and guests from all of our shows on the channel this year to come and share a cocktail here at the bar. But before I get them down here and liquored up to tell us all the secrets about what's in store for next year, I thought you and I could share one more special cocktail moment before all the craziness starts. What I've made is a special cocktail called the Snow Day, perfect companion for those days where the snow's got you trapped at home watching Netflix all day. To make our delicious dessert martini for your snow day, we'll only need a few ingredients. We'll start with some Hershey's syrup, or whichever brand you prefer, but Hershey's is the best one. We'll then add some softened vanilla ice cream, some vodka, and some Baileys. Let's go ahead and piece this together. As artistically as you possibly can, which for me means probably not at all, we're gonna swirl it in the glass. Only got some on the bar, that's not bad. We'll add in our softened ice cream. I'm gonna need something to stir with. Let's check my little kit. Aha, swizzle spoon. I'm gonna go ahead and soften the ice cream up a little bit more. This cocktail works a lot better if the ice cream is basically melted. You know, I've had a pretty good run of cocktail moments this year, even though I can't always seem to keep it in the glass.
We're gonna add some ice to start.
Big mess when you're doing it, that's the best way. Orange juice.
That seems like enough ice. And as usual, make sure you pour it all over your bar. Oop. Ooh. Ooh. Okay, we got most of it in the pitcher. All over the bar. Perfect, of course.
Why is it not coming out?
Keep it in the glass. All right, I think that's about it. Only a little spill there. Get that cleaned up. Oh, cheers. That's very tasty. Probably use just a little bit more vodka. And then we should get this bar cleaned up before our guests start to arrive.
Yo to Matt!
Yo to Matt!
Down here, fellas. Hey, look, everybody. It's Pete from the hit TV show LARP and Cosplay. Hey, Pete.
Hey, Matt. Hey, everybody.
And I know who you've brought with you today, but why don't you tell the audience who you brought to the special holiday episode?
Right. Manners. Hey, everybody. This is Josh.
Hey, everybody.
The Josh. Now, Josh, you have a new show that we've started shooting for 30-something Digital, but it has not aired yet, correct?
That's right. We've begun shooting, but the first episode won't air until next year.
Dang, our first spoiler for next season. I haven't even had to liquor you up.
You could still get us a drink, though.
Huh.
Nice.
Funny thing. I heard you liked the Shirley Temples in the mocktail episode, so I had to make you a special holiday version of the Shirley Temple.
Holiday? What makes it so holiday?
I added cranberry juice. Why don't you come around to the front bar? Let's have a chat.
Yeah, sure.
So you're having a Shirley Temple, too?
Absolutely. Mine's just going to be a little boozier than yours.
Or a lot.
So, Pete, LARP and Cosplay, been quite a ride. How do you feel?
Definitely been an adventure, that's for sure.
Absolutely. So, how do you feel about it?
Well, I feel like we've kind of just started to scratch the surface. We had a chance to look into costumes, prop making, putting the finishing touches on your cosplay. The other thing, too, is we've had a chance to kind of start looking into what type of LARPs there are out there as far as like some of the historical ones or fantasy-based LARPs.
I can't wait to see that. Your show's been one of the most popular shows, the highest viewed shows on our channel. Not that anybody's looking at those things. What do you feel is in store next year for LARPing cosplay? What do we got to look forward to?
We've actually already got a couple things lined up. So we've got a really fantastic interview with a professional cosplayer slated to come out sometime the beginning of next year. And then we're going to have a chance to start looking into exactly how many kinds of LARPs there are out there. The historical ones like Civil War reenactments or performance LARPs like Mystery Dinner Theater and things like that. So it's a ton of possibilities for us to look into from here.
That sounds really interesting and exhausting. Josh, tell us more about your show. For instance, what's it called?
Well, my show is called Cheat Day, and every episode we get to go enjoy a different decadent food.
Nice. Hence the name of the show, Cheat Day.
Exactly. But there's a catch. Every episode, I have to do some type of activity to earn our cheat day. And we've been trying to explore different, less common, more unorthodox ways to stay active.
Wow, that sounds really fun. And you said that airs starting in January?
Yep, sometime in January.
Nice. That gives me plenty of time to finish off all of the Jake Bakes, Holla Bakes, baked goods that are baked in my kitchen.
I'll help.
True.
Before that airs. Well, guys, thank you so much for joining me. Thank you so much for being on the channel. It's been a lot of fun working with you, and I can't wait to do more with you next year. And most importantly, thanks for representing the beard game in this episode.
Certainly.
Cheers. Happy holidays.
Cheers. Happy holidays. Merry Christmas.
Hello?
Matt Hunt, are you down there?
Down here, guys.
Hey, sweetie!
Hi, guys. Welcome. Kendall, what's up?
How's it going?
What's up, bro? How is 30-something Digital's newlywed couple? Kendall and Fallon.
Yay! We're great. Thanks for asking.
No problem. You guys had a lovely, lovely wedding. They did a costume wedding, guys. It was really cool. How was your trip in?
It was really good, but man, it was a little nippy out there.
Yeah.
Do you, by chance, have anything that could help with that?
Well, this being a show called Cocktail Moment, of course I do. I made for you guys hot toddy.
Perfect.
And Fallon gets a special glass for hers.
Aww.
Hot toddies, for the viewers, have hot water, whiskey, honey, and lemon. I made one for me, too. How about you guys come around the bar and we'll have a chit-chat?
All right.
Hey, Kendall.
Yes?
I love your new show.
Thank you.
As I recall, you actually both approached us with the ideas for your show.
We did, and may I say, you guys did an excellent job of putting them both together.
You're a flatterer, Kendall. Was it what you wanted? Did it come together the way you wanted?
I was kind of worried, you know, that it was going to come across the wrong way, but once it all came together, We got some great responses from parents and stuff. They said that they showed it to their kids and they absolutely loved it. Mm-hmm. I actually got some really good friends in Mississippi who said their daughter was just walking around the house going, Kendall reads books so you don't have to.
The tune is infectious, right? I find myself singing it all the time. And you came up with it on the set that day.
Totally off the cuff sort of thing, but it turned into a total earwig, you know.
It worked out great. We had Jake from Jake Bakes actually accompany it with a little of that harpsichord kind of sound. And it became really, really catchy.
I'm glad.
Another thing that I heard from several friends with kids that the younger kids really liked was your snort, the sound that's made in the book. Do you think you could just for our Christmas audience, give us one more good snort.
Snort!
Your voices are perfect, and I look forward to seeing more of it. I think the show really came together, and I think we might have been worried about what was going to come of it, but I'm really pleased with what eventually came together on that show.
Thank you.
I had some similar concerns about my show as well. I didn't want people to think that I was just trying to run a gossip column or that I was trying to poke fun at people's, bad situations. I wanted to acknowledge the fact that, okay, sometimes bad things happen and you're not alone in these situations when they happen. You've got me or you've got friends and family that can help you through them. And basically to realize that all bad situations potentially have a silver lining. You just have to look hard sometimes to find it.
Right, and it doesn't hurt to teach people a little manners and etiquette along the way, right? Did you get all your RSVPs in the end?
No. However, we did have several couples that showed up at the wedding that didn't send those cards in, and we really couldn't imagine our wedding it wouldn't have been the same if they didn't show up. You know, we were happy that they came.
Well, you guys, again, you guys had a great wedding. I had a blast. So thank you again.
Thank you.
You guys think that you're going to keep this going next year? We got more. I've got this, y'all, on Kindle Reads in the works.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, yeah. As long as you'll have us, we'll keep making episodes.
Well, I think there's demand for both shows, so I'm looking forward to more next year. I appreciate you guys so much. Cheers to you.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, yep. I imagine you guys have places to be, you know, family to see, right?
No.
Oh. Well, you know, I have other guests coming for the holiday special.
Oh!
That's good!
Yeah, yeah!
That's awesome.
Yep, they'll probably be here in a little bit. Probably gonna want to sit this general area of the bar.
Perfect.
Should probably go get ready for them. Get their cocktail moment ready. I'll go do that. I'll see you. See you guys later. Happy holidays. Thanks for coming.
Well, I'll... Okay.
Honey, can't you take a hint?
What?
I think Matt's trying to tell us that, you know, let's not overstay our welcome. We need to go.
Okay, well... Well, if we can't stay here, can we maybe hit up a pub? Do they have pubs in St. Louis?
Of course they have pubs in St. Louis.
Oh, okay. Well, I hope they don't have too much beer.
Too much beer? You can never, ever, ever, ever have too much beer. How could they have too much beer?
Oh, right. Candle reads books, so you don't have to. Candle reads books, so you don't have to. Candle reads books.
Hey guys, how's it going?
It's going well.
Pretty
Today's
good.
The holiday special, right?
Today is the holiday special. You just kind of snuck up on me all quiet like, and no one told me you were here. But welcome, everybody. This is Nick and Jess. Jess and Nick. They were from that fabulous episode of Let's Try Something New, where we did the Eat St. Louis food tour and had tons and tons and tons of authentic Italian cuisine.
Mm. Yes. It's amazing.
The Italian stallion. I want another one of those.
Was that what that was called?
It was. Well, roast beef sandwich with all the garlic. Oh, yeah.
I don't have an Italian stallion for you today, but I did make you special cocktails.
Mm.
I know you don't drink alcohol, guys, so I... made you a special one today. Some of our hosts earlier in the episode made the same decision, and I think I'm going to do it myself so I can get all the way through the rest of this episode. I made mimosas, but I used 100% sparkling white grape juice instead of champagne. So
fantastic.
Cheers to that.
I like it.
You guys want to head to the front bar and have a chat?
Sure.
Cool. Let's go. All
right.
Mm.
That is that's surprisingly good.
Thank you. Yes. Glad you like it.
I like that.
So, Jess.
Yes.
You have a podcast.
I do. You've been on it a few times. Just a few.
So I seem to recall right now.
You've also introduced me to some pretty awesome people that have been on it a lot.
Cool. I'm glad that they worked out for you. I'm very privileged to know quite a few interesting people that would be cool for that. And you've been so gracious as to only somewhat begrudgingly periodically plug our channel on your podcast. So for that, I'm very grateful.
Yeah. Still kind of waiting on those advertising checks, though.
And you'll keep waiting for a while. So tell us more about the podcast. Like, what's it about?
Well, Gateway Geek is a podcast for those who wonder what the geek thing is all about. The geek stuff has kind of hit the mainstream.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like a lot of people are interested in these things that are sort of popping up. And I wanted them to have a gateway to get into all the cool stuff that we all really enjoy. So I basically have some noobs and some experts onto the show, and we talk about all kinds of geeky stuff. So first season kind of covers broader topics like movies and television and games and even action figures. And in season two, we'll get into stuff that's a little more specific. We'll talk about a little Star Trek, a little Star Wars, a little Doctor Who, a little anime.
Star Trek or two.
Yeah, a little bit. Maybe a little Disney. mm-hmm. like you got going there.
I don't think anybody's really seen my sweater on the show.
I think it's really important they do. Mm-hmm. There you go.
I like it. I love
it. Well, cool. I'm a big fan of the podcast. I'm a little partial to it, obviously. But I don't listen to a lot of podcasts, but when I do, that's the one I listen to.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Now, I understand there's more than a podcast, right? You guys also have a production company, Lucky Underpants, I believe is what it's called?
Yeah. Yes.
Tell me
yes,
more. I want to know more.
Well, Lucky Underpants is our label for releasing media. Things like books, animated shorts, or little short films that are mm-hmm. live action, or illustrations. We like to use what talents we have. I'm an animator, illustrator, and she's a writer, as well as she knows her way around a camera. And we like to celebrate things that are kind of the depths and details about life, things like history and philosophy and even spirituality. And, you know, because we are who we are, we like to celebrate with a geeky flavor, things like sci-fi and fantasy, Lord of the Rings, Firefly, and we also really like the whimsical and mischievous angle, probably a little more childlike, hence our name. Just picture a very professional-looking production house with all the latest tech and very professional. Everyone get to your sets, and yet there's a great big pair of underwear flying from a flag right above it all. That's us.
I can see it now. That sounds great.
Spider-Man underoos.
Spider-Man underoos, the best of the underoos. Well, guys, that sounds great. We'll have to link some of your stuff and the podcast
sure.
for our viewers. And good luck with both of those next year. Happy holidays.
Thank you. Yeah. Merry yep. Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to us all.
Hell, who knows? Maybe this next year we could collaborate. Like maybe TSD and Lucky Underpants could do a project together. I was just thinking today, now that I've got you here, I could start scheduling maybe a project or like a web channel or a web video series.
Actually, wait. We have that thing to get to that
with the people that we know, right?
Yeah, it was
the people.
Yes. 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 Oh, that.
Okay.
That.
Well, family is important.
Yeah, we might need to.
Well, you know, maybe when you're done with family, you guys could come back around and hang out, and we could talk about the project and get something done. You know, schedule something, a collaborative.
Talk what?
Gotta go. Bye. We'll talk later.
Well, I guess we're done talking.
I told you we should have taken Gravois instead of Vandeventer.
You're the one that drove around the block six times.
I told you I was parking.
Oh, look, everyone, it's Jake and Jason.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, everybody. Sorry we're late. Not naming names that made us late.
That name would be yours.
What are you implying?
Oh, look, the pie, guys. Jake, what'd you bring us?
Since you brought something really wonderful to our show, I wanted to pay you back and bring something really, really wonderful, unlike, other guests did on my show.
Wow.
But yeah, it's this really delicious pie.
And what kind of pie did you bake today?
I made an eggnog custard pie because I wanted it to be festive. I wanted to, share in the holidays. And it's a little fun. It's baked custard.
Well, that sounds very festive and delicious.
It is, and it's so simple. All you do, if you have a neighbor that has eggs, go to their yard, steal them, then start cracking them, just whisk it together with some sugar, some whole milk. If you can milk it to yourself from a cow, perfect. It's my milk tradition. You want cinnamon, get yourself, it's you want some cream, things like that, sugar, whisk it together, it's larger than the pie, you're a little fresh, your friends, and it's great.
That sounds so simple.
It is.
I honestly can't wait to try that myself.
So, Matt, what drink did you concoct for us today?
Well, for my two special boys, I wanted to make something to match, as I anticipated, your very festive pie. I wanted to match that as best I could. So I made a spiked eggnog, which has peppermint schnapps, eggnog, obviously, as well as vanilla rum.
Mm.
And what we will do, besides making a giant mess,
keep it
in the glass, keep it in the cup. We're just going to dash a little cinnamon on top. Why don't you guys take these?
Eggnog, great knife.
Well, you're missing half the equipment there.
Oh, my. And on that note, let's take the pie and move over to the bar.
Perfect.
Ooh. Thanks, guys.
I don't even like eggnog that much, but this pie... Kind of fixes
Didn't
it.
Didn't you make the pie?
Yeah, but then I make things that people don't like all the time. Well, that I don't like.
That's not my experience. Mm. Jake, first of all, this pie is very good.
Thank you.
It's a shame that other people can't taste it right now.
Right now.
Here in this very room. So, I would say this past year, You and I have put out more episodes than anybody else on the channel, right?
I think so, yeah. But you know what? It's, for me, it's not about quantity. It's about the quality, really.
But, I mean, how does one even measure the quality of something like art, you know?
The number of views.
But who even looks at that?
I can think of a few names.
Jake, I've really enjoyed working with you this season, working on Jake Bakes. How do you feel? You think you're going to come back next season? We got more Jake Bakes in store?
I hope so. I've got a ton of things to bake.
What do you have in mind? Give us a little taste of what's next year on Jake Bakes.
I really want to do more savory things, because I know we focus a lot on sweets, especially with this holiday bake special.
Mm-hmm.
So I would love to do more savory things, like, you know, an olive loaf that's, like, braided, or I want to do a steak and ale pie featuring some local breweries, possibly. That's something that I really love to do. I love to feature some local artisans. I love to feature some of my friends in them. And maybe some new locations, who knows?
It all sounds super simple and easy and ready to share with family and friends while the children are out playing at the park.
You know, like you.
Well, Jason, I know a lot people haven't seen a lot of you on the channel this past year, but they did just get to see you recently in the Holla Bakes episode of Ice Gingerbread, a personal favorite of mine. That gingerbread was really good, y'all.
It was really good.
But most people probably don't know how integral you've been behind the scenes of 30-something Digital.
Thanks, Matt. Don't mention it.
I'm going to mention it, and I'm sorry. He's been great this year. He's been behind the scenes running cameras, running errands, babysitting Jess and Nick's kids so we can take them on a food tour. We didn't even bring them food. But really, you've been great.
Well, thanks. Don't mention it. I was really happy to help.
What I would like to do is see if you'd like to be on camera next year. You're kind of a charmer, right? You've broken some hearts in your day.
A couple. Yeah, I thought about it.
Have you thought about what you might want to do if we happen to put you on a show? Like, what kind of talents or skills you'd want to share with the rest of the class?
I happen to be a pretty competent bartender.
Well, you know, I'm sure we'll find something you can do on camera.
I don't know if you remember, but I actually taught you a thing or two.
I said we can find something you can do on camera next season, Jason. Boys, I want to just take a second and thank you very much for all of your help this year, for all of the baked goods that you have stuffed my house with this year, and happy holidays to you guys.
Happy
Cheers.
Holidays.
Happy holidays. We have a clip for Jake Bakes, right?
No, we don't have a clip for Jake Bakes. There's a new Jake Bakes on Friday, though.
He's out.
Tune in. Friday, Jake Bakes. Tell your friends.
Share, like, subscribe.
Well, everyone, that's it. We've made it through our very first year of 30-something Digital. It's been a lot of fun today getting to hang out with a lot of our guests and hosts and all the people that have helped make everything possible this past year on 30-something Digital. I only wish we had more time to bring on some more of our faithful supporters. It's my show. We can bring on more. You, come here. No, not you guys. Him. Come on. Get over here. Come on.
Stand next to me.
Right here?
Yeah, right here. Come on, closer. There you go. Now, any of you that read the credits, which I'm sure is zero of you, might have noticed a person's name who's in every single episode. He's my partner and co-producer, Tony. Tony, say hi.
Hi.
Is there anything you'd like to say? Or am I supposed to say something else?
Matt, I don't think this is in the script.
No, it's in the script because you wrote this. Do you not remember
I
this?
I did?
Yeah.
Where is it?
Any of you who read the credits know this is Tony. Say hi, Tony. Hi.
Oh, I did.
And then I say, Tony and I have worked side by side for countless projects, blah, 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 blah. He's a cool person, I guess. And this year we came together to make 30-something Digital. So then you say...
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I guess it is in the script, so, you know.
You wrote it.
Carry on.
All I do is just make things up.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead. Keep going.
What's my next line?
Oh, you're going to talk more about me.
Oh, I wouldn't have been able to do this without the help of Tony's dedication, creative mind, and... What is that?
Humble attitude.
His whatever-titude. Tony.
Yeah?
Would you like to say something to the audience?
Oh. Yeah, I mean... We should thank the audience, right? And...
What are you doing? Stop.
Yeah?
Listen up. Smile like way bigger with the whole face. There you go. Now try this again.
What am I doing?
You know what? I've got an idea. I've got a better idea. Hold on.
Okay.
This will help. There we go. Hold on. I got you. Drink that.
All of it?
The whole thing. Bottoms up. All better?
I think so.
Try again.
Well, we just wanted to thank everyone for their support, from our spouses to all of our countless friends and family that have dedicated the hours that they've spent on all of our projects. Matt and I both have spent most of this year bringing 30-something digital together, and we couldn't have done it. It couldn't have been a reality if it wasn't for everyone I just listed and so many more.
Whew. Good?
Yeah. But you know what my favorite part was through all of it?
Equipment failures.
Close. No, it was things like this, all the little moments that just sort of happened organically, all the little funny parts that weren't planned.
Yeah, like spilling ice.
Yeah, like spilling ice. You know what?
What are you? Oh God.
Come on, you know what I want to do.
He wants a clip.
Yeah, just one more clip video.
Okay, it's Christmas. One more clip show.
Okay.
Just do it.
Roll it.
What are you doing? What else?
I'm trying to make it work. How do you make it work?
Right there. With the audience.
Oh. Roll it.
You know, I've had a really, really great year of cocktail moments, and I hope you've enjoyed them, even if I can't always seem to keep it in the glass.
Action. I got shoes on.
I have a new... You have a... I almost said sharded. That's weird. I did not sharded.
Looks in shape.
All right.
Looks good.
Everybody quiet on the set, except the actors.
You quiet on the set. Oh.
Quiet your head.
I'll quiet you in a minute, son. I hate that whole sentence.
Well, thanks. I mean, I appreciate it. We've explored a couple of different times. What are you doing? Are you
laughing? I didn't mean to spat you looked out of your script.
I didn't mean
I
to.
I was like, what is he look? Oh, hi.
Jess and Nick from that fabulous episode of Not Working Cosplay. It's called... We've used 100% white grape sparkling juice. Or another way to say that is 100% sparkling white grape juice.
The Italian stallion. I want another one of those.
Was that what that was called?
It was. It was roast beef sandwich with all the garlic. Oh, yes.
I don't have an Italian stallion. I don't have an Italian stallion.
I really like your new show.
Thank you.
I think that... Help me out here. I'm killing it today.
Is it underneath or where?
Oh no.
Oh, did we lose it?
I mean,
it's in his pocket.
Shit balls.
Let's cut it.
I've been here.
That was great.
That's what I'm talking about.
That was great. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. That's what we need. I love it when
a plan comes together.
Right.
Yes.
That's yes.
Was that an outtake of this take?
Yes, I think it was.
Should we wrap this up?
We should definitely wrap this up. Guys, thanks for joining me here at the bar for this Cocktail Moment holiday special. We really appreciate you being with us all year. For Cocktail Moment and all the shows on 30-something Digital, we look forward to seeing you next year. Please remember to share this video with your friends, like it, subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. We'll see you next year. Cheers.
Happy holidays, everybody.
Happy holidays.
And a Merry Christmas to you, and a Happy New Year too. You know what would be great?
What would be really great right
if
now?
We had one of those shots from outside the window, like zooming out on us, like, and then snow starts to fall.
We don't have that in the budget.
We don't?
We can't do that.
Maybe next year?
Next year.
Next year.
Next year.
Yay.
Be good. Tip your waiters, or whatever. You're doing it. Do it.